In this video, I will explain how dialog requests are processed in SAP system, and also I will explain what is work process multiplexing. Before explaining that, let us read these points here. Processing dialog requests. The execution of dialog requests is characterized by the following. A program dialog step is assigned to one specific dialog work process during execution. Program dialog step is assigned to one specific dialog work process during execution. Each and every dialog step is assigned to one specific dialog work process within the SAP system during its execution. The individual dialog steps for a program consisting of several screens can be executed by different dialog work processes during program runtime. This is called work process multiplexing. Means single program will have different dialog steps for a program consisting of several screens. One screen by one screen will be displayed to the user while executing program that can be executed by different dialog work processes, not only single dialog work process, different dialog work process will work on that particular task to execute the program screens. So this is called work process multiplexing. A dialog work process sequentially processes dialog steps for various users and programs. This is illustrated in the following figure. Let us look at the graphic for clear understanding. See here. Dialog work process 0, and it is dialog work process 2, and this is dialog work process 2, and the program execution displayed this screen, that is PBO. This particular dialog work process has shown this screen. PBO means process before output. Once you enter the details into it, process after input will be there. And it will show the process before output again, and the work is handover to dialog work process 2, and then this work process will generate this particular screen and it is ready in front of the user screen. And at that point of time, dialog work process 2 is still free. That's why it will take that particular work and it will continue the work for showing different types of screens. So in this way, this work process will hand over the work from one work process to another work process. So it will perform one dialog step and it will become free for performing other user request, and it will perform one dialog step and it will become free for other user request. It may be same user or other user request, and next dialog work process will be available for performing other users request. In that way, whatever the work processes are available in the SAP system, all those work processes will perform different tasks of the different users. Okay, example, 100 users are there, 10 dialog work processes are there. So 100 users will try to communicate with 10 dialog work processes. So in that way, 10 dialog work processes will work as a semantically, so that it is called dialog work process multiplexing. So let us read some theory about it. SAP application programs differentiate between user interaction and processing logic. The user actions are technically realized using screens, also called DynPros, from dynamic programs, which consists of a screen image and the underlying flow logic. The DynPro processor of the work process executes the screen flow logic of the application program. calls processing logic modules and transfers field content to the processing logic. The screen flow logic itself is further divided into PBO, process before output, which is processed before the screen image is sent, and process after input, which is processed after a user interaction on the screen. The PAI part of a dialog step logically belongs to the preceding screen image, while the PBO part logically belongs to the subsequent screen image. The actual processing logic of ABAP programs is executed by the ABAP interpreter. The screen processor tells the ABAP processor which subprogram needs to be executed depending on the processing status of the screen flow logic. So with this paragraph, if we go to a system, real system, let us log on to the system and try to execute something so that you can see different types of screens available in the system. So let us create simple user account here using SU01. So this is one screen. Whatever you are seeing here, it is one screen. Okay, you just give one user, like dummy user, any user account. So once you provide the user account and click on the next, that is create button, it will show another screen, one screen to another screen. So whenever I am clicking on the create button, so it is doing dialog step. That means the dialog work process will perform this particular job. Okay, once the screen is displayed, the work process will become free. Right now the work process will not work. Okay, and now after inputting, like process before output, so whatever the input you are providing here, just provide the input and switch to another tab and give the password. Don't worry about creating user account, that is separate video. It is explained beautifully how to create user account. Just to explain the screen flow logic, I am creating this user now. Okay, so once you provide the initial password, now I am clicking on the save button to save this particular information. Now again it is user action. When you click on the save button, it is user action. That means the work process which are required for this particular action, like if you are saving, means it will update the information in the database. That means update work process also will work, and at the same time it will show another screen by the dialog work process. So available dialog work process will show the screen. Just click on the save button. So user one was saved and this screen is displayed. Okay, in this way screens will be changed within the same program. Whatever the program we have executed, that is SU01, from starting to ending it has several screens. So it is processing step by step, that is different types of dialog work processes are involved. So this work will be done by the work processes that can be seen from SM50. So number of dialog work processes are available here like this. Okay, let us go back to our reading. If during a dialog step data needs to be exchanged with the database or the buffers, then this exchange takes place through the database interface, which enables access to database tables, ABAP programs or the ABAP dictionary, among other things. So that's all about dialog work process multiplexing and what is the process flow for a dialog step involved in the SAP system. I hope you understood this well. Thanks for watching.